I don't know, with music I get to create music and I get to kind of just do my own thing. And with movies and TV shows and everything like that, aside from X Factor, I have to play someone else. And that's something that I've not really been interested in doing lately. I like doing music and performing, and I feel like what works best for me, there's other artists that can do that, but what's working best for me right now is focusing on one career at a time. The pressure about being a role model, it doesn't feel like pressure anymore because I'm being honest now, whereas before, I used to say, well, it's not fair, I didn't sign up to be a role model, I'm a singer, and that's what I want to do. I don't want to be a role model for people because I'm a teenager and I wanted to make mistakes and I wanted to do my own thing. But now that I'm being honest and I've kind of embarked on my own journey and I've learned that I can help people with the issues that I've struggled from, that's more about being a role model. And so now it's just something that, I mean, there's no pressure at all, and it feels really great.
X Factor, first off, has changed my life because it's gotten me in front of so many people, and it's been able to showcase not only my personality to a lot of people that typically aren't in my demographic, and it's been pretty cool just being able to open up like that and people getting to know me better. To be honest, when it comes to like people scrutinizing like anything that I do, it's gonna happen. Like, you're not gonna be able to please everybody. And if you are pleasing everybody, something's wrong, because then it's not really genuine. I don't know, I just feel like if I'm myself and I enjoy the clothes that I'm wearing or the size of my eyebrows, then you know what, whatever. I'm doing my own thing. So if people like it, great. If people don't, great.
Well, everybody on that wall over there, well, four of them.
Including the guy with the earpiece?
No, I don't hang out with them in my spare time, although we could get to know each other and be friends. I'm not opposed to that. These people aren't afraid to check me, you know, if I wake up grumpy and be like, hey, I don't appreciate being talked to like that. I'm like, oh, okay, I apologize. And that's something that I love having around me, is because in this industry you have a lot of people that will tell you yes, 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 and nobody will stand up to you and tell you when they think you're doing something wrong because they don't want to get fired or something. And I just don't have those people around me. I have friends that have my best interest at heart, and I spend as much time with my family as possible.
I think an artist can maximize chart success. You know, to be honest, I don't really pay attention to a lot of that. I honestly like making music, releasing it, and if it does great, amazing. And if it doesn't, we'll release another song next time. But for me, my life is pretty much about making music, and I let the label and everyone else handle how to make it successful. I've kept in touch with Cece, actually. Cece Frey, she was my last contestant that I had in my group, so I got to know her a bit better than the other contestants. But I know that she's working hard on her dream. I think I've seen Fifth Harmony a bunch around and about. I can't remember who else I've seen since the show, but I know that there are different. I've seen Emblem 3, I think. They were working with some of the producers that I was working with for my album. So everybody has been working on their own thing, which is really cool to see. And yeah, I don't know. Cece's really awesome. She's become a good friend of mine. Nobody in the world, no matter how mean somebody is, they don't deserve to be bullied like this. And so ever since then, I've just spoke out about that issue since I've been able to, since people started listening. If you are being bullied, speak up about it. And if you are witnessing someone being bullied, speak up about it. But it actually doesn't make you cool at all to bully somebody. What makes you cool is to hang out with the people that, you know, normally a lot of people are making fun of and trying to be friends with everybody. My family has been a big inspiration to me, my little sister mainly, because, you know, I feel like she's just I don't know how to word this, but she's my baby sister, and I just want to protect her from everything. So when I speak up about
my issues with eating disorders or whatever it is that I've dealt with, I want to make sure that I set a place where young girls know that they can talk about it and that they don't have to struggle about it anymore, or struggle with it anymore, and that's pretty much been my main inspiration. I'd be Demi Lovato hanging out in Singapore.
That will be sure. All right, fantastic. Thank you so much once again for taking your time, Demi. Thank you so much.